And this stuff's not easy to cut, is it?
Flip the camera around and let me do
a cut. Yeah, it's going to show me how to do it now.
This is all this is about is knowing how a material behaves.
Definitely.
And you obviously don't know how it behaves because this is the first time you've seen it up close and personal, ain't it?
Yeah.
But I'm holding the knife different.
Yeah, see the difference.
And then just gonna. The next challenge is to put this cut into one of your cuts. And I'll film you doing it.
Yeah.
And then where that's going is up there like that.
Right in the window.
That's the recess for the window. So chuck the camera back and you put that angle on that we need. Said you wanted to get involved, didn't you?
Yeah. I've got to do it from this side. Don't feel confident doing it that way. That's not a good edge anyway though, isn't it? I'm better to cut the other way, ain't I? Look, already going wrong, look.
Come out really well actually, mate. Now that's gonna go down there like that. The cut, like I say, that has come out really nice, yeah?
Yeah.
But if it didn't,
yeah,
all we'd have done was just put some bonding paste in there and just blending through. So the next thing is when we're doing before we do the floor,
yeah,
we'll bond these on. If you've got some screws, just stick some screws in, just fold it in place.
Yeah.
And then, you know, like the round that we put on the top.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We'll just take that sharper edge that's been created with that cup.
Just with the sandpaper again.
And yeah, as you saw with the other one, it's just a kiss and a slight kiss.
Right, yeah. Cut down through these again.
Yeah, you can do, yeah.
I found doing that cut, instead of just trying to go balls for it.
So with these knives, So keep an eye, you know, I think what was happening, you're like that and you can't see the line.
Yeah.
I had the blade right out like that.
So you can see it and pull with force instead of...
And just a continuous cut rather than...
Yeah.
It looked as if you were doing a bit of that to it.
Yeah, because of the material. It's a complete different material to what a bit of meat is.
Yeah. You were saying earlier, even just putting this foam on, mixing the stuff up, putting the correct amount of paste on the boards, yeah, and even, you know, dabbing them onto the wall, completely different to what you expected.
Completely different. Hell of a difference from what I thought it would be. And then we're doing the same angle again, aren't we?
So what you see on the videos I put up?
Oh, it doesn't do it justice, mate. Anyone that wants to have a go at this, I'll turn that off for them because it definitely is not easy.
And we ain't got to the fiberglassing yet, mate. That's the technical stuff. You'll be all right. You're gonna have a go, aren't you?
I'm gonna have a go, mate. Yeah. Is that one all right?
Champion, mate.
Champion. Same to this one.
Yep. Just making the additional piece that sits there like that, and that will be about 25mm. So by the time we've got some extra layers of glass over that, fills it out so the glass will fit flush the window brass that goes against there will fit plus with the finished fiberglass. So it don't help, James, that we're working in 27 degrees of heat.
Crazy, isn't it?
Yeah. Kept everywhere nice and tidy, haven't we?
Definitely.
You saw earlier how quick it runs away with you. You know, when you've got your scraps of your bits of foam and you don't pick them up off the floor, the place is in the right state, isn't it?
Oh, definitely, mate. It's definitely worth staying tidy.
See that last bit of that crap you did then?
Yeah, come in slightly.
No, I was just going to say, you're so much more confident with it now.
Yeah.
Only after four cuts?
Yeah, just feeling it, how it works, yeah.
It's just learning how the material behaves, isn't it? So,
definitely.
Given your time again, if you were to foam line a pond, you've got a much better idea, and that's where experience comes, that I've obviously got.
100%.
You know, makes it just go super efficient.
100%, mate, yeah. I mean, I certainly wouldn't have wanted to do it, not on my own, not experiencing what I've done so far. It definitely ain't easy, I know that much. I can put my hands to most things, but I think this job here would take me a long time to learn it.
The thing is, this is your one and only pond, isn't it?
Yeah, so you only get one chance at it, and once it's in, it's in. You
and
can't that, change it.
That pace, you ain't slowing it down, you ain't stopping it going off, are you?
No. As soon as it's mixed up, like you said to start with, you've got half an hour.
And that, if you were honest with yourself, that pace would have gone off on you, wouldn't it?
Yeah, 100%. 100%. I'd have still been flapping around on these streets. I'd have been flapping around here, from working out how to cut them around them and sorting that out. Yeah, looking all right, mate, isn't it?
Yeah, champion. Absolutely champion. Look at that. Beautiful. Really, really nice. Nice round of skimmer. So the next step is to just get these little shards out that we've created.
Yeah, get rid of them.
Sweep the floor up again. The tops of the walls have been done. Mix up some more paste. We'll mix it up at the same consistency we did for the walls.
Yeah.
And then this is how truly built the pond is, yeah? That gap is only because of the nominal differences in the foam, yeah?
Yeah.
Now, there is no, along that top joint, there's nothing to put bonding paste in. If I was going to be really particular, I'd smear a bit in there.
Yeah.
That one is definitely going to have some bonding paste, but that is the discrepancy within the foam, not the trueness of the build.
Yeah, so could be a little bit in there. I am honest, it could be a little bit in me building block work.
No, honestly James, I know how this foam works, so possibly smear a bit in there, but the resin will probably fill that. There's literally sniffing a little bit of paste up when we've got the floor and the window recess in. And then we'll just, you know, you'll see just a couple of little smears in, just to make up the discrepancy.
And this stuff, once it's down, it's all right to walk on, is it, before the resin goes on?
Good question. Find a little scrap piece.
See if it take my weight.
Just measure it. Just measure it now. Measure how thick that is.
Ten mil?
It's 12.
12?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right, stand on it first.
Full weight?
Yep. There won't be any need to measure it because you can just look.
You can look, there's nothing. Absolutely.
If anything, it's the slightest mark of your...
Of my trainers, yeah.
That's it.
And that's 13 stone on that.
And if you kneel on it...
Yeah.
If you drop him down and kneel on it... All your weight. Yep. See what it's done to it there, but
all the weight in one place.
Made that depression. Yeah. So we'll tend to like pad around on it, you know, with your feet.
Yeah.
And then to stop it doing any indentations in it whatsoever, that is what that primary coat of resin is for that we put on tonight. When we glass the window frame up, so we can bond the glass in while I'm in. Right, that'll do. I'm just going to take another break and we'll prep for the next little section. Yep. Break it down, section by section by section. Boom.
Sweet.
Just pull that off the rush down. Top.